least I took my boots off this time. I woke up on the wrong side of the truck bed this morning.
Today's video is gonna be a how-to plow with a pickup truck. Just a little background on what I'm driving right now. This is a brand new F550. It has the Fisher 9.5 XV2 with foot extensions, making this plow 11.5 feet at its widest point. We're taking care of a hospital, and we really don't use trucks here. We really do the plowing with skid steers and a loader. But what we do use trucks up here for is the loop road. This hospital basically has a circular road around the outside of the whole premises that goes around to all the buildings. I believe it's like 12 or 15 buildings, something like that. So what we do is we start in the middle of the road and we wing snow to the side. We'll usually do three passes, one kind of in the middle, and then the next two on either side. So we'll go the same way twice and the opposite way once, and that seems to work out pretty good. So this is essentially the first thing that we do when we show up to the hospital, is get the road done first, and then we work to our parking lots. So that's really all we use our trucks at the hospital for. So we go pretty slow because obviously, as you can see right there, that was a big manhole. So we try to keep our speed around 10 miles an hour anymore, and it gets pretty dangerous. So I'm coming up to the spot where you can see that I've already plowed. So I'll slide over all the way to the edge of the road and get the rest. So this is really all we use trucks for up at the hospital. We do have like 12 parking lots in a different town that we do a lot of pickup truck plowing with. And I'll kind of drive around here and show you guys how we plow with pickup trucks for parking lots or small parking lots. So these extensions that I have on this Fisher, they work great. One lane for this hospital road is about 12 feet. So I can just about get an entire lane with one swipe. Versus if you didn't have the wings on, then you'd really have to do four instead of three passes. I have a 12.5 foot custom made Fisher plow. That can do just two passes, one lane each way. From our experience, it's been really helpful to throw down some salt in between our plowing. So I have come up to the spot where I've plowed twice. A little bit more about this truck is, it is a power stroke diesel. It has the 10-speed transmission. My other 550 has a 6-speed, which I prefer. The truck has a 3-yard stainless steel caster on the back, with loaded with 100% salt. Currently on this truck, I just have a custom-made flat body. On my other 550, I have a dump body. The bad thing about the flat body right now is that when you're empty, it doesn't weigh really anything, so you get poor traction and very little push power compared to what you do with a dump body. Gives you an extra 3,000 to 4,000 pounds. So on all of our trucks, we have the same plows except for one. We all have the 9.5 XV2s, and the other one we have is the 10.5 XV2. We don't have any of the wide outs or the XLSs that Fisher makes. We don't have anything like that. So scoop with these V plows, I mean, it works okay, but it's definitely not the greatest. We get a lot of spill out from each side when we're in scoop, especially when there's a lot of snow. Even when there's just a little bit of snow, we still get spill offs. So we essentially utilize these plows for winging snow. So if we're plowing a open parking lot, which I'll do here in a second, what we essentially will do is we will start on the building side and push snow away from the building. And you never ever want to work your way in towards a building. You always want to move your snow away from your building. We also have backup cameras in each truck. Obviously you can't see on the GoPro there very well, but these are obviously very handy and they're what I think are essential for snow plowing. It's a good backup camera. I think that plowing without a backup camera is suicide, especially for somebody new or that you're training. High visibility wing guides. The black ones that Fisher comes with are basically junk. You can't see them in the dark. But those orange reflective ones are awesome. It's almost like they glow at night. So I'll do a little section of a parking lot for you guys just to show you how we go at plowing a commercial parking lot. We start by the building and we will wing snow away from it. Obviously, when you're in a skid steer, the benefit and why we use skid steers is we will be able to turn on a dime. So instead of backing up this entire way, you will just spin completely around and plow the opposite way, which is a huge time saver. So when winging snow, it depends on how much you have and if you have wings on or not, but we go 3/4 pushed over, we leave. And essentially you have to watch when snow is falling out, but you do not want to let any snow fall off. That way you have to go over it twice. And typically plowing anywhere from 1 inch to 4 inches, you can go about 3/4 of the way through your plow. If you're doing like a dusting, you can basically utilize your whole plow. And if you're plowing like a foot, you have to use like half of your plow. So doing what we do, zero tolerance, plowing this many times, we will wing our snow about 3/4 of the way through our plow. Obviously, if you had the room, which I basically do, to turn around and plow the opposite way, go ahead and do that. Obviously, just for the sake of the video, I'm not. Just to demonstrate to you, this is how we usually typically do it. So if I was to put all the snow right now into scoop with my plow, a lot of it would spill off to the left, and I would have to replow it again. Obviously, if you can use your scoop or you have a better plow that doesn't leave runoff, then go ahead and do that. These custom wings I find help out very much, especially with weight. So there you guys have it. That's a pretty simple way to plow, is just to wing snow away from a building. Thanks you guys for watching.